Hello. I have prepared some videos regarding this grain loading, but some of the friends sent some comments about this one. They are asking for if I make a video with this United States National Cargo Bureau form, calculation form about the grain. So I will make one additional video about this one. In this National Cargo Bureau booklet, they are at the end of the booklet. They are giving some examples regarding the calculations. The first one is the bulk carrier, example number one. I will not make this one because this is in feet cube and long ton. 99% with the grain calculations you will use metric ton and units in meters. Metric ton, meter cube, something like this. So I will make this. I will explain the example number two. Here is the bulk carrier. Okay. This one, the cargo hold 7 old bulk carrier. Only hold number 4 is slack. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 is full. These black colors are fuel oil. And this one is the... This one here is the fresh water. Okay. In the beginning, pardon. Okay, here. And then this is the page, the second page. Here. Şimdi cargo hold grain data. Fill it trim edens, fill it untrim edens. I have already explained about this one. I make it bigger. Here, I make it center. In the first pages of the grain loading manuals, they are giving you the information about this hold by hold, seven holds, total volume, net volume, this mean volume net, vertical center of gravity and the volumetric yielding moment. Four, filled and trimmed. And filled and untrimmed volume here, vertical center of gravity and the volumetric yielding moment is there. And the summary of the tanks. Here is the tanks. For peak, DBT, after peak. This is the capacity, this is the vertical, this is the free surface if slack. And fuel tanks, diesel tanks and fresh water tanks. Şimdi for this information, cargo hold grain data, I have already explained before. If you make fillet trimmed or fillet untrimmed, directly you will use this table. But for slack hold, you will open hold by hold. If you watch my previous videos, I have already explained about this one. Hold by hold, it is written. There is some diagram like this. Maybe they already give here, we will see. And here is the, for example, depth or allege, and then the volume, and then the vertical center, everything one by one. İşte inertia moment, everything is right at that table. So for example, for that vessel, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 are full. So if they use fillet trim edens, I will write directly this one. And if fillet untrim edens, I will directly write this one. But for number three hole, number four hole, this will be slack. I will not use that table. This table and the slack hole table in grain loading manual. For the summary of the tanks, I told you before in the previous videos. You don't write one by one like this. Okay, in your loadmaster computer. Everything is given. So otherwise you calculate how many metric ton inside, you take the liquid density, specific gravity, and then you make it metric ton, and then you open the table, manual sounding table, one by one for each tank, for that volume. This is the longitudinal center, this is the vertical center of gravity, this is the inertia moment, it will take too much time. You can, for these tanks, directly use from the loadmaster computer, because it's automatically calculates, okay. Same with the your approved ships tables, okay. So for this, we are taking from the loadmaster computer. And then you see here, pardon, I make it small first. Anyway, at first I explain this one. This permissible healing moment table. Okay, this is the also in the grain loading manual. I have already explained all of this in the previous videos. In the tables, where will you find? From the table, they only take one part. This for that displacement and for this KG, okay, not all the tables. So otherwise, what should you do? For example, this one, I open. This was the Chinese made vessel. Grain loading manual. For example, pardon. You see. For example, for the slack hold, here is the depth, here is the height, here is the allage, here is the volume, LC, longitudinal center of gravity, inertia moment, everything is written there in the. For example, for that vessel, you will use, you will open your grain loading manual and you will find hold number 4 and you will check according to the volume. In the beginning, actually, I want to show you the here, you see, for example, here, pardon, this one, for that table, pardon, here, hold data, fillet trim dense, fillet and trim dense. For example, for that Chinese vessel, we are calculating. I am opening my grain loading manual here. This is writing here. Already writing that. Grain volumetric shifting moment of filled loads with and trimmed and pardon. Şöyle. Grain volume shifting moment loads with untrimmed. So hold by hold cargo number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the volume. This is the longitudinal center. This is the vertical center. And this is the healing moment. Okay, so in the tables already written down. And for example, we just take the allowable healing moment table. You see here, for example, I open one of the page. Here. Sure, here I open the first page. You see, allowable grain shifting moment. I have already explained before. Grain shifting moment means grain healing moment. Each shipyard given some different names. It is not important. If you watch my previous videos, it is already explained. Here is the T, means the for that vessel draft, molded. And this is the displacement. According to this KG or vertical center of gravity, KG is equal VCG, all of them same. KG, keel to gravity, center of gravity, VCG, vertical center of gravity, all of them same. So it means this table is same with that one, this one. You see, permissible healing moment table. For that displacement, for that KG, this is the permissible values of the moment. For example, for the Chinese made vessel, this is the, they also give the trim displacement. For that KG, here is the tape. So, we proceed. Here, okay, they have already given the table, so we find the table. They are giving example, that is why they have only take that between these numbers of the displacement and between this kg. They already calculate before. That is why they just make only one part. For but for your vessel, for your grain loading condition, you have to find which draft or which displacement for which which kg. And I have already told you. I show you the hold number to you see. Here they have already. Pardon, I just rotate this one. Here you see they give us a one table. Why this hold number four? Because 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 are full. They will load full, but only number four will be select. So what will we do? Here depth from tank top or allage from allage from hatch coming. Here is the first one is the in cubic meter volume. The second one is the kg, and the last one is the volumetric healing moment. So what they calculate for the hold number four, they will load depth from tank top about 10 meters. So when they give us the specific gravity of the cargo, we can calculate the volume of the cargo, and then so tonnage of the cargo, volume of the cargo, so we know how many remain slack for hold number one. So in hold hold number four, sorry, and in hold number four, that tonnage will be how many cubic meter. So okay, for example, the volume, they calculate the volume about 6,000 cubic meter, means about 10,000 10 meters high. So okay, if 10 meters high, we continue. This is the volume, volumetric healing moment curve, this is the volume curve, and this is the kg curve. So we just for the 10 meter, we just take a line. We go down from the volumetric yielding moment, this value. We go here for the kg. We are coming to kg for this value, and we are coming the volume. Sorry, I told you wrong. The volume is about 7,800 something like this. For example, for the kg about 7.5 meters, and the volumetric yielding moment is about 11.8 thousand. 11,800. So it is same with that tables. Okay, in Chinese vessels, they are not giving you the curve always. Pardon, you see, pardon, I think maybe they give just a moment. Yes, for example, you see, they already give also one curve here. This is the same. Okay, for example, cargo hold number 3, this is the depth from baseline, this is the grain healing moment, grain volume, and the kg. This diagram is for manual calculation. You take the depth, take a line, and go down one by one. For each curve, you find the volume. This is same with that remaining. This is the table. This table, but this is hold number 4, they are giving at the end. Okay, this table for hold number 3. Okay, you see, so this table is same with that curve. Okay, they are exactly same. So but what I recommend you not use this curve always. It is better using these tables, because for the small digits you can make much more easy interpolations. Actually, this is also one by one calculated by the computer, but here this curves, the values are very high. For example, for 10 meter I come here for the kg, very small distance, just very very small. I go down, if I make interpolation, maybe not it will be the calculation will be not sensitive. Okay, it is better always use the table. Here for 10 meter I can directly make. Here between these two, I just make an interpolation and finish everything. Okay, this is same. Okay, we just continue. This is the curve. And okay, this is the calculation sheet. Okay, this initial part, the name, country, register, year of build, anything, just general information. Grain loading booklet, approved drawing, no something, something, loading port, Seattle, discharging port, Chittagong. Okay, from Seattle to Chittagong, China, they are discharging. Just steaming distance, miles per day, and time it will take the voyage. Daily consumption, fuel, diesel, water. Actually, here has to be written daily some production about the water if necessary. Anyway, but not written, okay, for the consumption. Summer displacement and displacement, deadweight, draught, air draught, I think this one. Yes, freeboard. It's right in that displacement, deadweight, draught, freeboard. And fresh water allowance. This one, fresh water allowance means only if written only fresh one. Already written, that's summer draft. If they tell you fresh water allowance and nothing, anything else, they say nothing. So it means for summer, okay? For summer, we just write here TPC, for summer fresh water allowance. This is the declaration, this is calculation, is prepared in accordance with the requirements, something like this. All the Australian and Canadian and the United States or any other, all of them same. The first page is the same. Here is the date, time, signature, name, print, something like this. Okay, for the next page, here is the cargo plan page. We just go ship and cargo calculation, part one. Cargo type, weight. Stowage factor 43 cubic feet long ton or 1.199 cubic meter in metric ton. And then they just write the compartment 1237. Here is the full capacity. Here is the actual capacity. They just here make it blank because these are will be full. Okay. Yes. And then number 4 is slack. Actually, why they change this one? Actual number 2. Number 1, okay, we just checked the storage plan. You see, here is full. Number 4 is slack, and number 1 almost full, but just little slack here, okay. Number 1 is also slack. So, this 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, we just use the first table, and 1 and 4, we just use the curve table, hold by hold, one by one, allege or depth. You can interpolate from the table and we will write. Okay, we just continue. Here is the weight. How we calculate weight? I just write here. Weight is volume divide storage factor. I have already write the all formulas here. But if you want, please you check my previous videos. Okay. Just a moment. Because sometimes they are complaining about the brightness of the TV. I just check the camera. We just continue. I think okay, it is not. That is why I am trying to read all the statements, sentence, everything on the table, because if not visible very good, so verbally I will tell you. And okay, we just continue. Here is the weight, how we calculate. Here is the moment. Moment we are finding also from the table. I show again one more time here. You see, here is one of the any cargo hold number 3. Here is the depth, here is the volume, here is the allege, here is the grain healing moment. This moment is this one here. This one. All the weight we calculate like this according to volume. Vertical center of gravity is this one here. Vertical. This one. This one is the vertical center of gravity. Here is the volume, longitudinal center, volumetric healing moment and allege. Okay, we are finding from the table or if it is already full hold, we are just directly, I repeat again, taking from here. You see this table. With trimidents or untrimidents, it is full. If full hold, volume is this, vertical is this, longitudinal is this, moment is that. Direct use that. But if slack, interpolate tables. Okay. We continue. Here, okay. This is the storage factor in cubic feet, long ton, metric cube, metric ton, metric ton, metric cube. This is density. This is just interpolation table. Okay, so how you find this? 43 is 1.119. We come here, 43, 1.199. So we can write here, okay. So it is just give you a guidance, not calculate manually from this one. Storage factor is 1 divided D. D is density, means density here. So it is just a quick the calculation table. Okay, we write all of them. Cargo total, this. Moment total is this. Light ship, this is vertical center, yes, vertical center gravity and the light ship moment is that. This light ship information, again, you will find from the typical loading manual, first pages, the ship's information pages or Graham loading manual, ship's particular pages, they are already given to you. So this is the total. So stores here, stores means constant, okay, constant. Vertical center of gravity of the constant and the moment of the constant. Okay, you can find this one at the end of the typical loading manual page, or just from the, it is better take from this loadmaster computer. Okay, directly take from store and the lightship, not search everywhere, directly take from the loadmaster computer. But cargo, and for cargo information you have to calculate. So ship and cargo total, here is the weight, here is the moment. Okay. Şimdi, complete these columns if more than one type of cargo is loaded. Hold number one, şey, column number one, which one is cargo? Ha, here cargo, if one type only write weight, if sometimes, okay, not write weight here, one by one, wheat, barley, something, whatever. I told you before, red lentil and green peas I load in Canada. So if like this, okay, red lentil, red lentil, green peas, red lentil, red lentil. So you just write the cargo type and storage factor same. If different, more than some cargos, okay. Each cargo storage factor you just write. Number two, for part the filled compartments, show actual cubic occupied in addition to full cubic. For partly filled compartments, show actual cubic occupied in addition to full cubic. Hmm. Okay, so you see here actual, because this number one and number four is slack holes, partly filled, so you just write the actual cubic meter. But for remaining holes, it is directly the full cubic. No need to write anything here actually. Okay, and weights and the moment should be shown in the nearest wall unit. Hmm. Okay, they don't want to you to write some digits after the comma. You just interpolate and the wall unit. Okay. And cargo plan indicate holds, twin index, engine spaces, etc. Okay, you just write about this your cargo plan. Okay. Actually, this is slack, but they write here slack, but don't write here slack, but in the calculations they write slack. Anyway, if it is slack, just write slack. If it is full, okay, fill it trimmed, fill it trimmed, fill it trimmed, fill it trimmed. Fill it trimmed, slack, slack, okay. Okay, this page is also we complete and continue the next page. Okay, I told you before, fuel and water calculation. For that one, you don't write all the tanks. You see, in the beginning, they give us, pardon, here, summary of the tanks. You see plenty tanks here, but when the calculation, pardon. Hmm. When they are making calculation, they are only write the tanks under use. Okay, it is important. If you write one by one, calculate from the manual sounding tables, it will take too much time and you will make mistakes. So it is better for that you just write only the tanks you will operate, and these values, all of this weight, moment, işte free surface moment, anything, you just write from the loadmaster computer. Okay, which values you will write? I have already explained. I repeat again. You just write the worst case scenario. Okay, which tanks you will touch? For example, here they will touch DBT number 4. Yes, DBT number 4, fuel oil, diesel oil, fresh water, distilled water, and fresh water again. Okay, drinking water tank. So you can make here like this: departure, intermediate, arrival. But what I recommend you, again, you just write the worst case scenario, okay? You don't use departure, arrival, make it blank, only write the intermediate here, the worst case, even if it is full or half or what. If you touch, take the free surface moment, always maximum, finish the story. Okay, I have already explained before. But anyway, they just take departure condition, arrival condition. Departure for Seattle, arrival for Chittagong. Here is the tanks, here is the weight, volume, metric center of gravity, moment, free surface moment. Okay, they just write here. Liquids total, and here is this one. What is this moment? Here is the free surface moment. Here is ship and cargo, total, total weight, and the total moment is there. Okay, also same for here. So departure KG. Okay. Anyway, okay, tamam. So departure KG is this one. So total moment divide total displacement, you will find the KG. Okay, free surface correction is there. Okay, and then here is the KG corrected. How we calculate this one, I have already explained in previous videos. Okay, so this departure KG. Okay, I explain again. Departure KG, you just divide the total moment to total displacement. Okay. And then for the free surface correction, you will divide total inertia moment to total displacement. And you will, this will be the GM correction. Name, other name is GM correction. So you will add this one. Why we are adding? I explain again. For the, what is the free surface correction? Here is the vessel, here is the keel, here is the G, okay, and here is the M, okay. So with this free surface correction, GM is increasing and GM is decreasing, okay, and KG is increasing. So for this free surface correction, for the first KG, we plus free surface correction, okay. So and then okay, we make the correction, but for this, don't forget, I repeat again, for this KG, bottom of the baseline or the extreme KG or the KG from the baseline. What I mean, the keel thickness correction. Okay, keel thickness correction. Okay, so this is very very important. That is why I have explained before. I am just calculating manually always this one and compare with the loadmaster computer. Okay, because if making the keel thickness correction, so your KG is increasing little more and affecting your healing angle in the beginning. Okay, very very important. Okay, we just continue. Okay, we just calculate departure key. Departure. Ha, this departure K PM, I explain before giving in the tables. Okay, grain loading manual. According to what? Okay, we just open this grain loading manual. For China vessel, I open first. Okay. You see, here is the draft. Here is the draft, here is the healing angel. No, pardon. This is not for this one, this is the next steps. In the QM, you just find from the hydrostatic tables. Pardon. Hydrostatic table, burada var mı abi? This QM means kill to mastery point. You find from the hydrostatic tables. Okay. I just check if I can find. I show you otherwise. For this QM distance, you can find from the typical loading manual. Okay. Actually, I didn't find the typical loading manual of that vessel because for the grain loading manual, we will use normally. I think just a moment. I just check quickly. Maybe hydrostatic table right in there. I think they only give the examples, not hydrostatic table, not included. No. Anyway, from the hydrostatic table, you find this QM, okay. Departure QG, we have already calculated, and departure GM, we find, okay. Also, arrival GM, we find. Şimdi, free surface correction. Already giving the formulas here. Okay. Free surface correction, how you make sum of free surface inertia moments divide displacement. I have already told you here. Divide displacement. And vertical surface moment correction, sum of vertical shifting moments for cargo divide displacement. Şimdi, first one, free surface correction. This correction must be applied to all ships. The second one, vertical surface moment correction. This correction applies only when vertical shifting moments are provided in the ship's grain loading manual. Yes, if they give you this information, so you just calculate, but they leave it blank, so there will be no correction. This is a different story. But for the bulk carrier vessel, no need to do anything. Just calculate, okay. So you just find one by one the inertia moment, free surface moment of the tanks, cargo, everything, vessel. Okay, here is the total. And then you divide the total displacement. So total moment, böyle total displacement give you the distance. Distance, the correction, 18 centimeter. So we just add, okay. For departure and arrival conditions. And then we just continue the other page. Okay, stability summary. Here is the compartment. Compartment. Okay, they already write part the fillet. Okay, stowage. Part the fillet. Fillet antrimut. Fillet antrimut. Part the fillet. Fillet antrimut. Fillet antrimut. Fillet antrimut. So, which tables in the beginning they just use? I open again. Fillet antrimudent tables, correct? This one, here. You see, fillet and antrimud. So they just use this table for the full holds. Okay. And then we come here, stability summary. Okay. So grain depth or allege, they write here. They use the allege because this is zero. Okay. Because if your hold is full, allege will be zero. Otherwise, depth cannot be zero. So they use the allege. Okay, here is the slack holds allege. In hold number one, 1.7 meter down from the hatch coming. in hold number 4, 7.8 meters, too much time, maybe the half. But the remaining holds are at zero, okay. Volumetric healing moment, we just take from the table. Here is the storage factor or density. They just use storage factor 1.199, all the same. And then grain healing moment. How we calculate grain healing moment? Volumetric healing moment divide storage factor. Okay. And I just want to check one thing, and I yes, okay. So I just want to tell one more thing about this one. Here you see, for example, in the tables, pardon, which one? This is part one. Here is part two. Okay, write in here free surface moment. Free surface moment. Free surface moment. Make like this is equal inertia moment. Inertia moment multiply with specific gravity of the liquid. Okay. So in the table, if I can find just a moment. Yes, density. Density here is free surface moment, inertia moments, and you multiply with the density or specific gravity of the liquid in the tank. Okay, so if I can find, but we need to find manual sounding table. Okay, so I cannot make also. Okay, I show you from here. From the cargo hold, it is all also same. For example, you see, here is the grain volumetric healing moment, M4. Also, inertia moment is M4. So, how we find the grain healing moment, volumetric healing moment, the white storage factor. Okay, I just explain here. For the cargo, for example, you find grain healing moment. Actually, for the tank, for example, ballast tank, fuel tank, anything, it's same with the inertia moment. Same. So, volumetric healing moment, sorry. Volumetric healing moment. So what we are doing for the cargo, for the finding grain healing moment, what I am doing? Volumetric healing moment, I am dividing storage factor, correct? But for the liquid tanks, it is same, free surface moment. Free surface moment is same with the grain healing moment. What I am doing here, volumetric healing moment is inertia moment. But, okay, you cannot make the storage factor. What is storage? What is this one? This equation is what? Grain healing moment is equal volumetric healing moment multiply 1 divide storage factor. Correct. Actually, this is same. Volumetric healing moment divide storage factor is equal volumetric healing moment you multiply with the 1 divide storage factor. So 1 divide storage factor, what does it 1 divide storage factor? Storage factor is 1 divide D, so D density of the or specific gravity, density of the liquid or the cargo is we make 1 divide storage factor. Correct. So what does it mean? For the inertia moment, you for the tanks, for the liquids, we are not using the storage factor, but we are using the density. So it is same, okay? Free surface moment is equal inertia moment multiply with the density. What is density for the tank? Same. 1 divided stowage factor. It is same. Actually, we are making the same calculation. That is why here in the table, when they are calculating, pardon, şuradan idi abi. You see, here moment. This is the grain healing moment. Total how much? Cargo, lightship, stores, all of them total 697016. We come to next page. You see, they just calculate. But this is different. No. This is okay. This is no. This is different for the. This is vertical center of gravity calculation. But for this one, liquid total, I just take just a moment. I think here it is here. Just a moment. Inertia moment. Where is it? Inertia moment for the cargo holds. They didn't take actually. Why? Anyway, okay. Okay, just this one is cancelled. Okay. You just, in theoretically this is same, but anyway, it is not included in the table. Anyway, you just memorize like this. For the grain healing moment, you find from the table volumetric healing moment, divide stowage factor. For the inertia, free surface moment, okay, divide. Free surface moment, inertia moment from the table times with the density of the liquid inside. Okay, or the specific gravity of the liquid. Okay, remaining forget. I just cancel because it is completely different and not included in that table. Anyway, but here is the moment, okay, for the liquid is the vertical center of gravity, free surface moment, already written beside column. But actually, normally for the cargo calculation also has to be written because this moment only for the weight times vertical center of gravity is the moment. This moment for the vertical center of gravity. But actually, normally another column has to be written of the grain healing moment hold by hold. Anyway, in this calculation sheet, it is not included. So we just continue. Okay. This page is okay. I just repeat again. We just write the all volume for the slack holds. Actual volume, we just write the weight. And then we just write the vertical center of gravity and the moment of the center of gravity. Okay, here is the total with the stores. And then we come to next page. Here is the calculation for the free surface moment of the used operational tanks. Here is the general average. And then for departure and arrival conditions, we just calculate. Here is the free surface moment column already writing here. Here is the column for the vertical center of gravity moment. Okay. So this one we divide displacement. We apply the correction. We find the kg for the km. We find from the typical loading manual. And finally we find the arrival jam. Actually I don't remember with the previous Australian and the Canadian forms. In the forms, it is included beside the vertical center of gravity moment. Maybe hold by hold, grain healing moment column is included or not. I don't remember. But anyway, just use this to finish the story. Okay. Okay, we just continue. Okay, for this one, the next part of my video, I just continue from the part number 3. Thank you very much for watching. Okay.